Hi, this is Toby with HMC Electronics. We're going to be doing a review of the types of Kester bar and wire sorter. So here we have a sample of a couple of different types of Kester products. I've separated them here by leaded and lead-free. We will start with the leaded sorter. You've got a couple of main alloys, SN60 and SN63. We're going to go really basic here. SN60 and SN63. The SN is your tin content, so your tin content being 60 or 63%. The remainder of the balance is lead. In the bar sorter right here, this is an ultra pure. It is just tin and lead and nothing else. When you go into your wire sorters for electronics, for the wire sorters, we're typically seeing them being a cored sorter. That means it has a flux content in it. There can be a 1, 2, or 3% flux content. And your flux types are as follows. I just rattled them off for you. You've got a rosin flux, or otherwise called your fully activated rosin core, your RA core. That is the easiest to work with. However, it leaves the most residue behind after the sorter is, a sorter joint is completed. It's got an instant wetting action. It's just very easy to work with, but there are applications where a rosin core will not work. Another flux is the Kester rosin mildly activated. Doesn't work as easily. It's not as quick to wet. It's not as easy to work with. However, the mildly activated rosin, we do see applications for that. It's less aggressive, the flux. And for certain applications, a less aggressive flux is more suited for that application. When you're looking at your alternatives, you also have no clean and water soluble. No clean, pretty simple, no clean. You don't have to clean the residue that is left behind. Similarly though, just as with the rosin mildly activated not being quite as good as the fully activated rosin, the no clean is the hardest to work with. It is the slowest to wet and therefore the slowest to solder with. You've then got, lastly, your water-soluble. So this is a completely organic flux. It's completely water-soluble, so you can wash it away. You can wash away any residue. There are applications where water-soluble is preferred. Again, looking at the removal of the residue, it's definitely the easiest to remove. But again, it is not as easy to work with. It's not as quick a wetting action as the fully activated rosin. Now, you're lead-free. First and foremost, their bar is this really cool triangular shape, so you don't mix up your lead-free bar with your regular leaded bar. Why lead-free? We have seen a movement over the past probably 10 years now, less than 10, 8 years, since about 2004, for something called RoHS compliance, the removal of hazardous substances. Lead is one of those substances. So a RoHS compliant or a lead-free sorter obviously has no lead in it. So this bar is 96.5% tin, 3.5 silver, and 0.5 copper. That is called a SAC305 alloy. That is the most common lead-free sorter on the market. It is a little pricey because it does have that silver content, but this was the first type of lead-free alloy we're moving to. Just as with the standard leaded sorters, you're going to see no clean, water-soluble, mildly activated, fully activated flux cores. So it mirrors the leaded sorter in its flux content. However, it is different in its alloy, so it's also a little different to work with. You're going to see that a lead-free sorter, the actual alloy, not the flux, the sorter is actually more aggressive on your soldering tips. So if you move from a leaded application to a lead-free application, you're going to see your tip life is going to go down, but that's the price for RoHS compliance. If you have any questions on either leaded or lead-free sorter, we have a ton of information on our website, but you are always welcome to drop us an email or pick up the phone and give us a call here at HMC.